Hi all, today we are going to discuss about dielectric stress in single core cables. So let us take the cable, because cable will have a conductor, and surrounding the conductor there will be an insulation, and outer side there will be a sheath. That means there will be a sheath at this point, and inside there will be a conductor. Let us take the diameter of the conductor. I am taking as small d, so that the radius becomes d/2. Similarly, the diameter up to the inner sheath or inner side of the sheath, so that I am taking as capital D, or the radius I am taking as capital d/2. So let us try to calculate how the dielectric stress will vary from as you are moving from the center of the conductor to as you go outside. So we know that inside the conductor, that is an equipotential surface. So inside the conductor, the electric field intensity will be equal to zero, and electric field intensity will be maximum at the surface of the conductor. And from there, the electric field intensity will go on decaying as you go away from the conductor. So if you want further details of this, you can please refer to my electromagnetics lectures on EMFT. So there I have taught the equipotential surface in completely detail. You can please refer from there. So inside the conductor, why electric field intensity is equal to zero. So there I have taught the conductor when kept in a electric field, how it is going to behave. Please refer that lecture. So I am proceeding further. Let Q is the charge per unit length of the cable. Per unit length, the charge that is traveling is equal to D. So we can find the electric field intensity at any distance x from the surface of the conductor. That means let us take, for example, this is my point where I am taking, this is my distance x. It is from center of the conductor, but this x is greater than the radius of the conductor, or x is greater than d/2. This is given by q by 2 pi epsilon into x. These units are in volts per meter, where x is greater than d/2. So this is what we have seen in electromagnetics. So generally, the value of this voltage, the instead of voltage we represent this as kV, and instead of meter generally it is represented by kV per centimeter. This is the practical unit that generally it is measured. As you can see here, it is a ratio of voltage per meter or kV per centimeter. It indicates how, what is the dielectric stress at a particular point, or it indicates what is the gradient of the voltage, how the voltage is changing. That's why this E is sometimes represented by G. So this I can represent by Gx instead of Ex. That means Gx is nothing but Ex. This will be equal to Q divided by 2 pi epsilon into x. So generally these units, they are represented in kV per centimeter practically. So I am writing this, where this value of x is greater than or equal to d/2. Only above that, greater than or equal to only, it will work. Let us take it as equation number 1. So now, if you want to calculate the potential difference between any two points, we know potential difference is equal to minus negative gradient of the electric field intensity, because we are moving away the direction of the electric field intensity. Always the electric field intensity will be from higher potential to lower potential. That means we have to do the integration from lower potential point, or the d/2 outer radius to inner radius. So that is d/2 at the surface of the conductor. We are taking from inner radius of the sheath to the surface of the conductor. This is Ex dx. So this I can write as integration from d/2 to d/2 q divided by 2 pi epsilon x into dx. So this will become q divided by 2 pi epsilon into ln of capital d/d. So let us take it as equation number 2. So from this equation, I can write that q divided by 2 pi epsilon can be written as v divided by ln of capital d/d. So let us take it as equation number 3. So now I am substituting this equation number 3 in equation number 1. So I can write my value of gradient, or the potential gradient, or we can tell the Ex will be equal to v divided by x into ln of capital d/d. So that means we, instead of q by 2 pi epsilon, I have represented this by v by ln of capital d/d there. So this will be in kV per centimeter. Please remember this one. So now from this, we can tell that here, as the radius or the distance from the center of the conductor is increasing, so automatically the value of the gradient is changing. So when this value will be maximum? When x is equal to minimum. And this value will be minimum when x is equal to maximum. Or we can tell the gradient will be maximum at the surface of the conductor. The gradient will be maximum here. And as we are going, the gradient will go on decreasing. That means here it will be maximum. Here the gradient will be minimum as you are going away from the conductor. And remember here, this is for x greater than or equal to the radius of the conductor only. We have to take that one. So from this we can tell that the maximum value of gradient will be equal to v divided by, the surface of the conductor is having a radius of d/2, ln of capital d/d. So this will be equal to 2v by d into ln of capital D divided by small d, this will be in kV per centimeter. Let us take it as equation number 4. So similar is the case, the minimum gradient I can write, it will be at the surface of the sheet, so it will be at d by 2, that is the radius, into ln of capital D by small d. That means x is equal to d by 2, at that distance it is happening. This will be equal to 2v by capital D ln of capital D by small d, this will be in kV per centimeter. Let us take this as equation number 5. Getting it? So now if you are taking the ratio of maximum divided by g minimum, so this will be equal to capital D divided by small d. So let us take it as equation number 6. So now whenever you are designing the insulator, if you are taking a conductor, so there is an insulator between them. So every insulator will have a dielectric strength. So dielectric strength is how much voltage it can withstand per centimeter, that is called as a dielectric strength. So while designing the insulator, the dielectric strength of insulator should be greater than the maximum gradient that obtained, or the maximum value of the gradient obtained at the surface of the conductor, right? So it should be greater than that. Generally the factor of safety also is considered. So we can tell that the dielectric, the strength of insulation should be that maximum value of the gradient, that should be multiplied by a factor of safety. Or we can tell always, if your dielectric strength of the material is fixed, then you have to design the value of the G maximum will be equal to the dielectric strength of your material divided by the factor of safety. So based on that, the value of the G max should come, because we know the maximum value of G max is depending on the value of the radius of the conductor. So you have to adjust the radius of the conductor to get the, so that the maximum value of the gradient will be minimum, or the material is not stressed more. So let us try to calculate the most economical size of conductor in a cable. So how to calculate the most economical size? So we know the value of the G max is equal to 2V by D into ln of capital D by small d. This is in kV per centimeter. So before proceeding, I want to tell you, I am providing the complete handwritten material in the description of the video, because here I am writing on the glass screen. So writing the theory will be very difficult and it doesn't come properly. So you can please download the theory from there. Here you try to understand the conceptual things. So remaining things you can please refer from there. So practically the voltage of the material, or the voltage of the conductor and the diameter, that the diameter are fixed due to the design constraints. Due to the design constraints, these two will be fixed. So only variable that will be there is the radius of the conductor. Let us see, how should I vary the radius of the conductor so that the maximum value of the gradient will be minimum. We know that the G maximum will decrease if D into ln of capital D by small d is increased. Everyone agree with me? So I want to maximize this value so that G maximum will be minimum. That means we can tell that the maximum value we can calculate by D by the differentiation with respect to the d, or the radius of this denominator. Denominator is d into ln of capital D by small d. This should be equal to 0, because it will go on varying the value and it will reach a point where the electric field or the gradient will be minimum. So the curve, if you draw, it will be like this. It will go on varying like this, as you are varying the value of small d. So there will be a point where this gradient will be minimum, and after that it will increase. So I want to find this point. So at this point, slope is equal to 0, or we can tell the rate of change is equal to 0. So denominator, I am maximizing it. So if you are maximizing this, the d by dt of uv. So this will be u into derivation of v minus v into differentiation of v. So in that way you have to get it. So this will be d into d by differentiation of ln of d by d. This will become small d by capital D, into differentiation of capital D by small d will be equal to minus d by d square. So plus, the differentiation of d will be 1. So this will be ln of capital D by small d. This will be equal to 0. Or from this I can tell that ln of capital D by small d will be equal to 1. Or we can tell that capital D by small d will be equal to e. This will be equal to 2.718. This is what we get. Or we can tell the value of the small d will be equal to capital D divided by 2.718. So if you are substituting this, we will get the maximum value of the gradient under this condition will be 2v by d into ln of capital D by small d will become now equal to 1, this is what we have derived. So this will become equal to kV per centimeter. Let us take this as equation number 8. So now practically what happens? So if you are calculating the value of the diameter of the cable using this, there are some different constraints which should be considered. So if you are going for the low and medium voltages, so from this equation number 8, so we can simplify the value of the D is equal to 2V by G maximum. Everyone agree with me? So we can tell that the diameter is directly proportional to the voltage and inversely proportional to the maximum gradient. Generally, the maximum gradient is decided by the dielectric strength of the material. I already told you. So this is fixed. So we can tell this D is directly proportional to value of the applied voltage. So if you are calculating for the low and medium voltages, the value of the D that is calculated is very less, and it cannot carry the required current. So as it is very less, so automatically the current density increases, or the conductor cannot carry the required current, because the radius or the diameter that is calculated using this method will be very small, that cannot carry the required value of the current. So that's why always the diameter of the cable is decided from safe current density point of view. So for the case of low voltage cables, whereas if you are going for the high voltage cables, so for the high voltage cables, so for high voltages, again the D is equal to 2V divided by G maximum. I told you G max is equal to constant. As the G maximum value is fixed, as the voltage is increased, so automatically the diameter that is obtained will increase. That means we can tell for the high voltage, whatever D that is obtained is more than what is required as per the current carrying capacity of the conductor. That means the radius is coming more. So if the diameter that is obtained is more than the required thing, so automatically the cost increases, because the cost of the conductor will increase, weight of the cable will increase. So in order to avoid this disadvantage and to follow this method, so what we can do, so we can use the different techniques. First one is, so first we will use aluminium instead of copper. So if you are using the aluminium conductor instead of copper, so the size of the aluminium conductor in order to get the same conductivity is of bigger size compared to copper. And we can go for the ACSR conductors or the standard aluminium conductors, so that the diameter will increase. This is the first technique. And the second technique is, if you want to use for the copper, then you can go for stranded copper around a central core of hemp. So you can keep the hemp in the center, and around that you make the stranding of the copper conductors. This is the second technique. And the third technique is using a central lead tube instead of hemp. Instead of hemp, we can go for even the central, you can go for a lead in the center. So let us take one example so that this concept will be completely clear to you. So I am taking, consider a safe working stress of 100 kV per centimeter RMS in a single core cable operated at 130 kV RMS. Find out the internal sheath radius if the conductor diameter on the basis of current carrying capacity is 1.5 centimeters, and the second condition on the basis of greatest economic use of insulating material, on the basis of economic use of the insulating material. So let us try to calculate how to calculate this one. So first one, it is already given the diameter is equal to 1.5 centimeter, and the maximum gradient also mentioned there. the maximum gradient is 100 kV per centimeter, and the voltage is also given, that is 130 kV. All are given in RMS, so no issue. So now the value of the G maximum will be equal to 2V divided by D into ln of capital D by small d. This is what we know. So from this I can calculate ln of capital D by small d. This will be equal to 2V by G maximum value into D. So everyone agree with me? So from this I can calculate ln of D minus ln of small d, because ln of A by B is equal to ln of A minus ln of V. So we can take it to the second side. So 2V by D into G maximum plus ln of small d. So from this I can calculate my value of D. So this I can write as 2 into 130 divided by 100 into 1.5 plus ln of 1.5. This will be equal to 2.139 value. So from this I can calculate my value of D is equal to ln, it will go to the second side, so it will become e to the power, so this will become 8.48 centimeters. You will get it as 8.48 centimeters. So it is asked the thickness of the insulation. So the insulation thickness from this I can calculate as capital D minus small d divided by 2. This is 8.48 minus 1.5 divided by 2. This will become equal to 3.49 centimeters. So let us calculate using the second method. So using the second method, we know the maximum value of the gradient will be equal to 2V by D. We have just derived, or we can tell economic size of the conductor D will be equal to 2V divided by G maximum. So this will be equal to 2 into 130 divided by G maximum is 100. So this will become equal to 2.6 centimeters. Or from this, we know the capital D by small d is equal to 2.718. And from this, I can calculate my value of capital D is equal to 2.6 into 2.718. So you will get it as 7.0668. So from this, I can calculate the insulation thickness. Insulation thickness will be equal to 7.0668 minus 2.6 divided by 2. This will be 2.334 centimeters. So in our previous example, we got the thickness of insulation as 3.49 centimeters. So here the thickness of insulation required is only 2.334 centimeters. Whereas we got the diameter of the conductor or the radius of the conductor using this method, we got as 2.6 centimeters. Whereas in the previous example or the first part, we got it as 1.5 centimeters. So that is the difference between these two. That means we can tell if the conductor size is small, then thickness of insulation will increase. If conductor size is big, automatically the thickness of insulation will be decreased for the same value of or the same type of material which is having the same dielectric strength. Getting it? I hope this concept of dielectric stress in a single core cable and the formula for the most economical conductor size and where it is used and where it is not used is completely clear to you. If you still have any queries, you can leave your comments in the comment section below. I will answer to your queries from there. Thank you. Thank you very much.